Zap, go back to the room. You should have just stayed in there, Zack. What was that, Zack?
Exercise. How far you can run!
I'll squash you like a frog!
You're an annoying little bug.
I want to see how far you can run. Keep your eyes to the front.
You're an annoying little bug.
Ha ha ha! Emily, I will avenge your death. Just a moment longer. I'll buy you a new dress to make up for all the pain I've caused you. The dress you wore when you came to my hotel room didn't seem to fit you right. Kacen, I've been meaning to tell you this. You're one crazy guy.
Come on, I'm right here.
an annoying little bug.
Because you don't understand humans.
Emily, York tries not to show it, but he's pretty shy. Don't wait for him to propose. Just ask him to marry you. Previously during the investigation, York, the other me, my other personality.
There are some things in this world that must be extracted, no matter what.
York, I'm sorry,
why can you cause me pain? Red tree!
York and Zack, finally I understand. You two really are best friends. I'm a little jealous.
I'm sure he'll make you very happy.
Are you leaving today?
Maybe.
Zack, that story I told you the other day, did you believe any of it?
The fact of the matter is that I couldn't save Emily. So it really doesn't matter whether I believed you or not.
I'm very sorry about her. There's something mysterious about that picture. There's a calming beauty to it, and yet it exudes sadness.
Harry, I have a few questions for you.
About what, Zack?
Your last name isn't really Stewart, is it?
No, that is correct. It's really Woodman. Harry Woodman. George was my son.
You were there in the White Room when I was there. Why?
The same reason as your father. Long, long ago, I too was unable to shoot my wife. What's worse is that I was also unable to kill myself. Which is why I lost both. The woman I loved, and my son. My wife suffered from a mental illness, but I still loved her. I wanted to save George too, if I could. Everything was my fault. If only I had the courage to make the right decision, Emily and the other girls would not have died. But you have put an end to all of that.
I wonder if they are happy.
Zack, no need to worry about that. York will guide Emily and the other girls into the forest.
Hey, Michael. Mind stopping the car for a moment?
Very well, Mr. Francis Zack Morgan.
I heard you're leaving.
Uh-huh. That's right.
It's a shame about Emily, and the other girls, too.
How are Isaac and Isaiah?
Oh, they're fine. They still don't think the girls are dead.
Give it to him yourself. He's right next to you.
Oh, okay. I understand. We'll do it for you.
Emily kind of told us to give this to you.
Emily said it's a present for Zack.
Thank you. Where did you get this?
Emily asked us to give it to you. See? She's over there.
There's another Zack there, too. You're twins, just like us.
Emily couldn't give it to you herself. She said she's too embarrassed. So, she asked us to hand it to you.
Emily really likes you, Zack. She really likes you.
No, she doesn't. Not me. She really likes that guy, York. The guy you see standing next to her. Anyways, you two. Be nice to the girls, okay? And they'll be nice to you.
We don't like girls.
Girls are boring.
Thank you.
Gotta love him. Just full of energy.
Emily, York, sounds like you're both doing fine. I feel better about you two now.
And hey, York, I figured out why George carried on his body all the way into the woods.
It was for them. He wanted Isaac and Isaiah to find her.
Mr. Francis Zack Morgan, if you are finished, if you are, please, let us return to the car.
No need for that. You can go home. I want to take a look around more.
Very well, then. I'm sure Mr. Stewart will approve of that.
Ah, thank you, Michael.
York, can you hear me? I'm a little jealous.
I'm all alone on this side now.
But don't worry, York.
I've had it easy for so long having you with me. I need to get used to being on my own.
One more thing, York. I hope things are going well with Emily.
You've always been horrible with women. I gave you tons of advice during your last relationship, and you ignored all of it. I'm sure Emily will take the lead. Just don't fight her. Let her steer you in the right direction.
York, tonight I'm going to sleep like a baby. Zach, it's over. All finished. It's time for you to leave town. Are you ready to go? Then this is goodbye, Zach. Thank you for everything. Good night, Zach. And sleep tight.
Polly, what's that picture?
Oh, that. We took it when the clock tower was built.
50 years ago?
That's right. That's me in the middle. I was pretty popular back then. Men were always around me. Sorry to keep you waiting. Just sign here, please. Mr. Morgan? Mr. Morgan!
Oh, I'm sorry, Polly. I was just thinking of a friend. Someone who was with me for a long, long time.
He must have been a really good friend, then. Otherwise, why else would you remember him at a time like this?
Indeed. We used to fight, but he really was a good person. He's gone now, though. Gone away to a place where we can't meet again.
I'm sorry to hear that, but if he's a friend of yours, I'm sure he's getting on just fine.
Thank you, Polly. You know what? I think so, too.
Lord!